Insurance, serving Guam for 80 years. Matson and the Adaiatano Program. Harley-Davidson of Guam. Visit our new showroom, now located on Route 8 in Mitee. IP&E, fueling excellence. McDonald's of Guam, I'm loving it. And King's Restaurant, located in Tamuning and Dedado. Always open, always local.
Thousands head to the polls to vote on Super Tuesday. The island welcomes home a fallen hero who died during the attack on Pearl Harbor. And we'll tell you about an upcoming event pushing buttons for Saipan and Tinian.
Half a day and good evening. Voters made their way to cast their ballots less than 2 hours before the polls are set to close. Our team of correspondents went around the island speaking with voters and candidates. We begin our Super Tuesday coverage up north with Crystal Paco.
Polls are open.
Dozens up north flocked to the polls before making their way to work on Super Tuesday. Voters like Gino Salas, who are looking for candidates with
passion for the people.
Salas tells KUAM he's most interested in the gubernatorial race.
Confident in people I voted for.
The 27-year-old was one of the first at D.L. Perez Elementary School when doors opened at 7 a.m. Also at the polls bright and early, John, Jennifer, and Sierra Sevilla, who've made voting a family affair.
I want to make sure we, we get heard. So of course, we all have our own opinions with things. So there were some things that we were kind of like, not agreeing on, so.
Nevertheless. But that's the beauty, because everyone gets to decide what they want, and it's their own individual choice, and they have to make that.
For the youngest voting Sevilla, it was her first time casting her vote on Guam. Sierra explained she had some jitters of her own, so she came prepared and did her homework.
I didn't want to mess it up.
What were you thinking about messing it up? How?
I mean, I know that obviously before it was you can't cross over, whereas now you can. So we had a lot of conversations about that. And then just in general, just making sure that I've done my research to pick the candidates I think that represent me and my views. These topics are very important to me, so what candidates stand on these sides with it? And so just kind of going off of that and listening to speeches. Obviously there were ads, there was lots of ads, but yeah, just trying to vet them personally.
Mom and Dad, meanwhile, share their biggest concerns as residents of one of the biggest, most populated villages on island.
More crime for us, yeah. Because, I think it's just a little bit more dangerous nowadays. Yeah. And, you just have to be careful out there and make sure that the people that you vote in are the people that gives the best interest for everybody, not just for me, not just individually, for each one of us, but as a whole, for Guam as a whole. So that's the most important thing for us.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Crystal Paco. Yes.
Thanks, Crystal. Now to a report from our Nick Delgado, who is covering the election in Central Guam.
The crowd started their Super Tuesday off early in Tamuning at John F. Kennedy High School.
It was very smooth, very easy. Directions were explained very clearly.
Voters like Jessica Lozama have been keeping watch on the campaign trail.
I just listened to what all the candidates had to say. I stayed informed and I listened to what the opposition had to say about both sides.
Each one ready to mark off the candidates on their ballot.
It's exciting to vote. It's an interesting election.
In Sinahanya, voter turnout for today's election was off to a rather slow start. Village Mayor Robert Hoffman.
A lot of people are working, so I wish it was a holiday, but I think and I do hope that people of Guam come out and exercise their right to vote.
But the pace was a plus for voters like Peter Cruz.
Oh, everything went smoothly. Yeah, very professional, and everything there assisted and explained the process clearly.
And from parking to curbside voting, then to the instructions given as you get your ballot forms, precinct officials definitely enforcing what's happening here at the sites, and voters then getting one of these.
What do you got on your shirt there?
Oh, yeah, a medal from voting.
How do you feel? How do you feel about voting?
Okay, good.
And the people working the precincts are trained, double trained. Even as me as an experienced voter, I make sure they're doing their job, so I want them to read me the list. I want them to say my name. I want them to ask for all the IDs and not just to assume things that they know.
Volunteers were also on site helping voters make their way in and out. Guam police officers on hand to provide security throughout the day. Overall, a smooth day for voters in the central part of the island.
I've lived here for for quite a while and everything, and picked the person I thought would do the best job.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, Guahusi Nick Delgado.
Thanks, Nick. And finally, we sent Nestor Lucanto down south for a look at the voting down there. Nestor.
It was a beautiful day for an election down south. We saw a slow but steady pace of voters showing up at the polls, from Talafofo to Inarahan down to Maleso, Umatic, and Agate Santa Rita.
Viva Boomers!
The village of Agate was our final stop, and by that time the traditional supporters' tents were in full operation. Each of the gubernatorial camps were represented, as well as several senatorial candidates. How do you think the election is going so far?
Good, very good. A lot of crowd. People are so enthusiastic, so we're doing good.
This is my rooster. I've been following this team for a long time.
How's it going so far, the campaign?
And I feel so good. Just that, you know, it was a different area to be voting before, was up here. And, you know, I was just new down here in this area.
It's going to be a very exciting day for all. History's going to be made, for sure.
So the campaign is going pretty well?
The campaign's doing great. Change is definitely coming.
It's going to pick up soon. You know, pick up soon. People are still at work, but later on it's going to pick up, you know, and, you know, we know we're going to see a lot of excitement here.
No question, it was building. From down south, I'm Nestor Lucanto, reporting for Guam's News Network.
Now, in a nonpartisan race to elect Guam's next attorney general, two lawyers square off for the coveted seat. Carmen Tulahi reports.
The race to become Guam's next attorney general is between first-time candidate Levin Camacho and former AG Doug Moylan, both taking the time on Super Tuesday to vote.
It's been fun so far. You know, we started up in Jigo. I vote in Dededo, so we're slowly making our way down south.
I'm feeling optimistic, hopeful, and respectful of the fact that today we're bringing this to a close and the people get to use their democratic right.
For Moylan, it's his experience as Guam's first elected attorney general that he brings to the job.
Guam's AG is unique. I served it in 2003 to 2006. The attorney general doesn't go into court and make nice with people. They're taking away people's freedom that are accused of wrongdoing by juries, people in our community, and they're supposed to do justice.
For Camacho, a first-time candidate, he wants the opportunity to address public safety.
This is the time. I mean, I'm 40 years old, I got two young kids, this is the home that I want to leave for them, and it just felt right. I think you need to be very tough on violent criminals, so we've seen a real rash or spike in violent crimes. We need to make sure that we punish those types of offenders to the fullest extent of the law.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Carmen Victoria Tirlahi.
If you haven't voted yet, you have a little under 2 hours, because at 8 p.m. the polls will close and ballots will be secured to be transported to the election central at the UOG Calvo Fieldhouse. Matter of fact, that is where Jason Salas is standing by live. Jason.
All right, partner, thanks so very much. And Hafaday Guam, and welcome to a wonderful election day, one of the most celebrated times in our great island's history, a time when you and I can make it out to the polls, cast your vote, let your voice be heard, let everybody know what change you want on the island to bring about the next great set of issues in our island community. Follow me around the room here, because you now have less than 120 minutes to do exactly that and make your voice heard. Over here on the right side of your TV screen, that is where the voter registrars will be starting at 8 o'clock when the polls close. This is going to be bustling with activity. 67 precincts in our island community in all. Each of the island's municipalities will be represented there. The voter registrars, volunteers, each and every one of them will be tallying up the ballots before they are submitted to the three machines, Tano, Manglo, and Gwefi, Earth, Wind, and Fire. Those are the machines who have the dubious responsibility for tallying up the ballots. Now, the issue that remains, because there was only one ballot you had to fill out as opposed to the three that you had to do in the primary, how will the potential write-in candidacy hurt, and how far set back are we going to be? But with all those write-in votes and tabulating those, we will see as we begin our live election coverage. That happens at 10 o'clock. Let's go back to Harmon now with more.
Thanks, Jason. Again, we will be covering Election Central tonight and well tomorrow. Our coverage begins at 10 p.m. with live reports from all the gubernatorial camps where the Republicans and Democrats are gathering. Also, during our coverage tonight, we will launch our campaign for a cause to raise money for the victims of Super Typhoon Yutu. Stay tuned. More news after the break.
Cheers to
to 80 years. It's our 80th anniversary, and the gifts are on us. 80 gift certificates, 8 shopping sprees, 8 staycations, and 1 round-trip flyaway for 2 to Manila. So how do you enter? Calvo's Insurance personal home and auto customers are automatically entered. Non-Calvo's customers may enter by receiving a qualified quote. It's our way of saying thank you for trusting us for the past 80 years. For more details, visit calvos.com/giveaway or call 472-6816. Calvo's Insurance, serving Guam for 80 years.
This election is about the soul of Guam. It is about life. Your vote will be the voice of the voiceless.
Before you vote, please ask yourself, who will respect all life, the unborn, infants who survive abortion, foster children, and arm and uncle?
Who will be a governor to all who call Guam home, no matter where they're born?
Who will invest in your children so they set their own path to success?
We will empower people through education to harness opportunities, get higher salaries and better jobs.
Tony and I will pay your tax refunds in weeks.
We will get GMH, a dedicated funding source it desperately needs.
God willing, under Tenorio administration, Guam will have more visitors and a thriving economy.
We humbly ask for your vote for governor and lieutenant governor.
God bless Guam.
Si Zeus Maas.
Maraming salamat po. Thank you.
I'm Ray Tenorio, and I approve this message.
Sometimes I feel like I'm all alone. I get lost and I can't find home. I look around for familiar faces. I get blinded by the empty spaces. Now a change is coming. Yeah, a change is coming. I see the poverty in the streets. I feel the water rise above my feet. Luxury condos going up next door. A tree is falling and there ain't no more. Now a change is coming. Don't you know the change is coming?
I'm Lou Leon Guerrero and I approve this message.
Let's go.
I'm Marie Cummings. I'm voting for Joe.
I'm Nila Horario. I'm voting for Joe.
I'm Nila Biscocho. I'm voting for Joe.
I'm Lorna Malipo, and I'm voting for Joe.
I'm Lyle Cummings. I'll vote for Joe.
I'm Virgie Horario. I'm voting for Joe.
My name is Amor Yanes, and I'm voting for Joe.
I'm Dado Rason. I'm voting for Joe.
Please select Joe San Agustin for Senator.
Vote Joe San Agustin.
These are our islands, and this is our Laddie Stone. This is what we stand for and who we are. For more than 35 years, we delivered connections that matter throughout the Marianas. First, via radio link, then by fiber optic cable. We launched the region's first 4G LTE network and continue to make our network faster and stronger. Telecommunications change the way our islands interact with the world, but not the heart behind those interactions. ITNE, explore your world.
My name is Levin Taitano Camacho, and I'm running for Attorney General. I grew up in a normal family. My dad is retired Army. My mom put herself through college and is now an educator. And I went to law school because I wanted to help people. That's what I've been doing for the last 13 years. I've seen firsthand how important the Office of the Attorney General is to our island, from prosecuting criminals, to ensuring that child support is being paid, to guiding the government of Guam agencies and directors. As Attorney General, I want to make sure that we build safer communities for our families. I want to make sure that child support gets to the families that count on that money. And I want to make sure that the government of Guam stays on the right side of the law. I am excited about an opportunity to serve the people of Guam, and I humbly ask for your vote on November 6th. Thank you. I'm Levin Taitano Camacho, and I approve this message.
Hafaday and Mabuhay, over the past year, you have welcomed us into your homes and shared your views about the way things have been and your ideas of what they can be. We've listened, and your hopes for our future have fueled our campaign for positive change.
Lou and I have plans to grow our economy, including tax breaks for small businesses, fixing our roads and infrastructure, and investing in education and technology. We will increase police in our villages, focus public health on prevention, regain GMH accreditation, repair schools, and keep our children safe.
This election is about our future, and we believe that everyone who calls Guam home deserves better.
Our best days will be ahead if we reach for them together.
I will be a governor for everyone, no matter who you are or where you come from. I am Lilian Guerrero. I approve this message, and I humbly ask for your vote. On November 6th, let's make history together.
Hafidin, welcome back to Primetime. A solemn ceremony was held at the airport last night to welcome home fallen hero, Petty Officer First Class Ignacio Camacho Farfan. He died during the attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7th of 1941. Earlier this year, his remains were identified as part of a defense POW/MIA accounting agency project to identify the victims who died during the attack on Pearl Harbor. From the village of Hagania, he was 21 years old when he died. He enlisted in the U.S. Navy in September 1939 when he was 19 years old. Farfan, a Navy steward mate, was killed in action while serving aboard the USS Oklahoma. He was interred along with 429 of his shipmates in unknown graves at the National Memorial Cemetery of the Pacific in the Punch Bowl Crater in Honolulu. Farfan will be laid to rest with full military honors at the Guam Veterans Cemetery on November 8th. The expansion of a key northern junction is finally finished. Officials cut the ribbon on the $7 million Route 1 and Route 3 intersection widening and improvement project. Funding was provided by the Defense Department as part of the Marine relocation. Construction began in December 2016 and was projected to be completed last November. Public Works Director Glenn Leon Guerrero.
Finally, we're here now. And I want to say thank you. I know that a lot of the hardships and the challenges that we went through weren't necessarily the change orders, but we ran into H-2B issues. And I know that MIDA, they hired subcontractors, and the subcontractors were supposed to come up, that usually come up with 60 employees. When they came to work, they had one or two, and that's what we're hearing. And so, or six people and stuff like that. But at the end of the day, they made it happen.
The turning lanes from Marine Corps Drive to Route 3, which leads to the planned Marine Corps base, were widened and reinforced to accommodate heavy military vehicles. Route 3 is also undergoing similar expansion work. To commemorate their second anniversary, the Guam Museum signed the Hafidin Pledge. Guam Museum Director Dominica Tolentino presented how they will incorporate the pledge into their daily work and promote the Chamorro culture. The program is Guam Visitor Bureau's cornerstone local community branding campaign. More than 700 private businesses, government agencies, nonprofits, and children have signed the pledge since it started in 2009. Stay tuned. Dave Delgado is up next with sports.
Hafidin. Kwaho si Lulian Guerrero, malalaguhaman si Josh, padigunaisan mo amin ni Itanota, Ikutirata, Zanitautauta. Bula pribamata ginigi islata, loti mekat man mafa amaling.